Now I've taken the electrics off, I want to take this off behind the steering wheel and see what's behind there. So I'm going to do that. Oh God, how long is this screw? Oh, hello, the whole thing's just... Oh! The whole thing's just descended. You know those two screws that go through the roof into the fiberglass above? They're not actually holding anything on. Oh. Right, well, I don't think this necessarily wants to drop, as it is trying to do. Oh! Right, well, that's just clinging to the carpet, so let's unscrew that by hand. Okay. Ah, oh, hello. Oh, hello, electrics. Well, that actually came off a lot easier than I was expecting. Of course, it was secured by one screw at the bottom, holding the whole thing up. The ones that are going upwards weren't into anything. Let's pop that there for a second. That is one thing of fiberglass mould. So it's obviously how it was supposed to look, albeit this wood is not pretty, is it? And it's got bits of gaffer tape holding it together. Also not pretty. Oh, maybe not holding it together. Maybe they're holding a wire or something. Well, if it's fiberglass, why has it got this grotty wood on the outside? Or is the fiberglass onto the back of the grotty wood? Who knows? Who knows? It's a mystery. Let's throw some more little bits of junk away. Let's not lose that screw. We might use it again. And what we can see now, can you see this? Yes, I think you can if I hide there, is the back of the steering wheel. There's the relatively new wiring that I think I'm right in saying is put in by the previous owner for the little LED, the little flat reels of LED lights that he's run round the boat. I don't dislike those, but what's this velcroed on here? Oh, right, there's a wire that disappears into the carpet and the velcro is just hiding where it disappeared. What's this bit of velcro doing? Absolutely nothing. What about that bit? Absolutely nothing. That bit of velcro is holding on the sensor, because these flat LEDs had a little remote control, and that is the sensor for it. And then they disappear off underneath. Do you know, this all must have come out fairly recently in order to put those lights in. So that's a positive, because it means it must be removable. What's that bit doing? Nothing. Random bits of velcro. And, oh, okay, this is partially labelled. At least that's labelled horn, which is good. There's a negative bus bar, and then that's a negative bus bar. I don't want to start fiddling with this too much. That's a fuse on the positive going to a rather unpleasantly wrapped junction with a bit of gaffer tape around it. Ugh. Then there's more of these LED lights. For the sake of understanding the boat electrics, I might take the LED lights out, and that will then simplify the wiring. We do have the answer to, can you see that? I'll bring the camera closer. We do have the answer to where that conduit went, because it comes up here and feeds, well, in some cases, absolutely nothing. We've got two dead ends coming up out of that. Then we've got another dead end wrapped with sticky tape. Dear me. And more dead ends wrapped with sticky. That entire thing, everything coming up of that piece of conduit is a dead end. But then we have actual positive and negative coming out of that one, which feed the bus bar and the things like the horn and the LED lights. I'm going to take off everything feeding the LED lights and also try to remove whatever this was. There's two separate bits of this white conduit. And I think that's the one that comes from down below, and that one disappears off somewhere else. But as it's entirely disconnected, it doesn't matter. You would not believe how much gaffer tape I've removed from here. There was gaffer tape along there, there was gaffer tape along there, there's gaffer tape holding bits of wires together. The horn, this is the back of that control panel that I want to turn that way round, because it's annoying me that it's the wrong way around. I tell you what, I'll show you, hang on. There it is from the driving position, and you can see it says light and running light and cabin light, and it's facing that way. It needs to turn so that you can read the writing on them. But there's those three switches with fuses above them, a battery test switch, and that's the horn. And then you have this other weird little thing. What the heck is this, with just two little holes in it? I've no idea what that is, but there's wires going to it. So again, looking at that from the back, that's the voltage meter, that's the horn. Those are the three switches for the cabin lights and whatever, and the running lights, with a little bus bar across them for the positive. And then here, this is positive and negative, just going to the back of that random thing with the two little holes in it. And they're very, very thin wires, and they just go down. There's a rather unpleasant junction here wrapped in sticky tape, which is taking that positive. And then where's the negative gone? The negative is at least screwed into the bus bar. While we're talking about the bus bar, what do we think of that connection? Oh, yep, that's nice. And that is coming up from down below. That's the main negative from the batteries, just kind of held in by blind faith there. Oh dear. I think that's an old supply to the panel, because do you remember in the first DIY video I found random battery connectors in the back cabin? I think that is where that emerges, because the current battery supply coming out of this white one gives us a fresh earth, ground, minus whatever you want to call it, minus 12 DC onto the bus bar there, which is the same bus bar that other grotty one was just connected to. And then the red one with the nasty connection on it goes all the way up through a fuse, thankfully, up to the bus bar on there. So I think the actual 12 volt connection for everything that's running at the moment is this one, which means that that one is defunct and can be pushed back and taken back to wherever it came. It does occur to me, as I sit here literally deciphering this as I'm talking to you, that it's not the most gripping piece of filming. I am aware of that, but I'm documenting the refurbishment, and this is documenting the refurbishment, so we're kind of stuck with it being what it is. I know it's not the exciting pulling the carpet down, and I use the word exciting very loosely there, but for me, actually, getting stuck into this wiring is kind of exciting. That's the kind of nerd I am. I'm fascinated by where this spaghetti of wires is all coming from and goes to, so bear with me, eh?
I think that goes around that screw, so I will have to take that off. So it does mean we're doing a bit of decarpeting. After all, here we go.
That comes out of dust, whatever is holding it in. That falls away. Another random piece of inexplicable wiring removed. However, that is a sufficient length of wire that I'll keep that one. I won't bin that. I can reuse that.
Good. And oh, what?
I was sort of imagining
that these screws screwing the carpet into something would be going into wooden battens, but they appear to be going straight into the fiberglass. Well, surely that's a recipe for just leaks. Ah, no, it's more intelligent than that. It's a fiberglass batten. The roof is about an inch higher. Okay. Random bit of Velcro covering up another screw hole. Right here, next to the hatch, there is what appears to be a solid chunk of fiberglass, which is for screwing things into. Maybe it's got a wood core, I don't know. That's what's taking the screws. All right, let's take another one out and see what happens. See, I've got distracted again from doing the electrics now to doing this. Is there, everywhere there is a screw? Yes, there is. Another sort of lumpy bit in the fiberglass, which gives you something to screw onto. That is great, because I was thinking I was going to have to put... Hello, I'm down here. I was thinking I was going to have to put some battens in the ceiling, but it looks like they're already there. Arguably better if I show you. You see this lump of fiberglass here, and the actual top of the boat is up here. So this is just a lump, possibly a wooden fiberglass clad lump, into which the screw there screwed, and then over there there's a screw hole there, and that goes into another fiberglass bump. So there is some thought gone into the fiberglassing to give you something to screw into, which is good. Also useful, because I was going to put a couple of ceiling lights in. I know there's all the strip lights, but I was going to put a couple of ceiling lights in, and I wasn't sure how to mount them. But if there are things up there, I can screw them into the things. That is very useful indeed. Pulling down this side, I noticed firstly this is a fairly bog standard kind of cheap, it's not, what would you call this kind of wood? Thin wood. It's not plywood. It's a sort of cross-hatched kind of wood. I don't know what you call it. But also I'm noticing somebody's given it a bit of extra adherence with sticky expanding foam. Which is going... It's fine. Presumably they were finding the screws weren't giving them enough grip. So they've given it a bit of expanding foam. Well, that can come off. That's easy enough. And I will keep this bit of wood as a template, I suppose, if I can get it off in one piece. I just got distracted again and went back to the electrics and pulling wires through, and you missed a brief moment of excitement when, as I was pulling a negative wire through, it very briefly brushed the top of the positive on the battery. There was a spark. Thankfully, just a spark, but it was quite a loud spark, and quite a bright spark. But I was pulling it through, so it just touched it and carried on. So no fire, no major panic, just a brief heart attack. So nothing to worry about. However, the wiring's definitely getting a bit more cleared up now. Here, for example, going off to the right and the left, port and starboard, that will be the navigation lights, the red and green navigation lights. So I've disconnected them just so I know what they're doing. And then over here, you remember there was a second bit of white conduit where all the ends were just terminated. Well, I've pushed that back through and it comes out. Do you remember all this random stuff? Well, it's this one. Just conduit that terminates in nothing, and then it disappears round to the back of the boat. So again, I think that's to do with where the old battery terminals were. So I'll disconnect that, and not today, but at some point try pulling that through. And then we've got this, which is the one that I showed earlier that I said must come from the old batteries, and lo and behold, I've pulled that through. And it disappears up there and goes to the back. The upshot is, I think I'm doing a fair job of pulling out the old wiring that should have been taken out whenever it was truncated, and that will clear things up. And also getting to grips with
what limited wiring there is in this boat. There really isn't a lot. You've got the horn, you've got the interior lights, you've got the exterior lights. That's about it. So it's very simple, but I don't like all the things dangling off other things secured with gaffer tape nature of it. So I'm going to have a bit of a session on that at some point. Probably towards the end of the refit. I'm just taking it apart now because I can't stop myself. But we're getting there.
This is practically criminal. That little light wire that goes off to the weird thing with the two dots on it outside has been taken as a feed off this main positive coming into a bus bar. But look, the wire's just been stuffed in the end, and then that's some sort of black sealant holding it in place. It's literally a bit of sealant holding that wire onto this 90 degree terminal. Oh dear me. But if I knew what that strange little thing was with the two holes, anyone know what that is?
Well, having taken the electrics apart and cut all the wires and taken off the spurious wires and left myself only with one puzzle, which is where the horn connected, because there's a button for the horn and there's wires for the horn, but I haven't seen any wires coming out of anywhere that would actually lead to a horn, so that's a little puzzling. So having done that and started ripping the carpet down, I've sort of got to the point where I've had enough for the day. You know, when your brain reaches a certain I've had enough point, I think I've had enough. The boat's going to have to be left in a bit of a state of chaos. The electrics are off, so it doesn't matter that the few wires remaining are dangling, because it's only when you pull them through like an idiot that they spark against the red terminal. As they sit, they are fine. And I think I will just take stock. Go home and take stock and come back and carry on next time. So thank you for watching, if indeed you have, because this has probably been very painful for both of us. But hopefully, see you next time, or you'll see me, because that's the way that video works. Cheerio!